the aside, okay, the aside, the student of English literature, I think that they have heard very well of this word aside. So what is aside? You have heard about dramatic monologue, about soliloquy, and there is also aside in drama. We always find aside. So what does it mean? Actually, aside is also just like a soliloquy. But soliloquy is much more lengthy in comparison of the aside. Means we can say that the aside is the shortest. Okay, it is the shortest form of the soliloquy. Shortest form, it may be two words or it may be few lines. But if we make a comparison of the aside's length with soliloquy, then we can find that it is not as lengthy as is the soliloquy. So, soliloquy is often very serious because it presents spiritual conflict, mental conflict, or inner conflict. On the other hand, the aside is not so. It is not serious or it is not so personal. Means there may be a humor also. So, the aside is first of all that it is also used in drama, okay, not in any other form of literature, but it is always used in drama. So aside is the shortest form of the soliloquy, and it is just like a passing thought. Okay, passing thought means any idea or any emotion, any kind of thought comes or passes into the mind of a particular character, and that is uttered aloud by an actor, okay, and that is also uttered, or that is also spoken loudly by that particular character in front of other characters. Means other characters, they are also present on the stage, they are also performing their role, and that particular idea is also expressed in front of all the characters. But like soliloquy, whether they are present, means in the soliloquy maybe there is no person, okay, there may be an absence of other characters, but in the aside it doesn't happen. There is always the presence of other character or any other character also on the stage, but just like soliloquy, the other characters, they are supposed to not to hear even a single word from that aside or from that character. So in front of other characters it is spoken on the stage, and who are not supposed to hear it. So now, just like soliloquy, because soliloquy was also criticized being unnatural, being artificial, so the aside, it is also supposed to be very unnatural. It has also been criticized by the critics that it is also as unnatural as the soliloquy, because how can it be possible that other persons are also in front of you and you are saying, you are expressing yourself, or you are saying, or you are stating something, and others are not able to hear you or to listen to you. So the aside is also as unnatural as the soliloquy, but it is also another form of the soliloquy, right?